The devil arrogantly approached Christ. Satan the devil confronted the anointed, ordained Christ Jesus with self-deceived confidence. The devil approached Christ Jesus ready to use that which so often defeated mankind before. With his much fair, deceptive speech, the devil, with deluded authority, no doubt carried about him a subtle air of prideful arrogance. The devil, with intentions to deceive Christ into sinning, approached Christ Jesus with confidence. With Christ Jesus being in the same appearance of sin defeated mankind, I feel sure the devil felt he had a territorial advantage. Whole soul targeted. With the targeted areas aimed to defeat the purpose of Christ Jesus, the devil in some disguised manner approached Christ Jesus. The combined deceptions which the devil planned to defeat Christ Jesus with were the same as with Adam and Eve, preselected to capture the complete soul. The devil, having observed Christ, whom he intended to defeat, felt with confidence his chosen method could cause Christ to be defeated. The complete soul of Christ was specifically targeted by the devil, using seductions he felt would appeal to Christ Jesus. After Christ Jesus had been through a 40-day fast, which I am sure involved prayerful periods of contemplation of his ordained role, Christ Jesus, I know, strengthened himself with the unfailing word of truth. We can know Christ's way of strengthening himself because abiding in Christ keeps us strengthened. Christ Jesus has given us the way to have victory over temptations by telling us to abide in following him. Christ Jesus, after baptism and the Holy Spirit's anointing, was given words of encouragement from his Father. The Father spoke words that worked to provide great encouragement to Christ Jesus. I am sure the words spoken by the Father were words that kept Christ in the spirit of who he was and why he was sent. The words of the Father followed Christ to complete that which he had been sent to accomplish as the Son of God in the flesh, who became the Son of Man.